right, that is the shed. Happy Monday! Yes, we made it through another weekend, and my, what an interesting weekend it was. Today is November 9th, and I hope everybody's well. I'm just popping on quick to say hi, and that's it. I had a relatively normal weekend, just like any other. On Friday at work, I received a freebie. The light bulb over my desk burnt out, so I threw it in my bag and I brought it home, and that's gonna get hung on my Christmas tree. I know you have no idea what I'm talking about. Why does Clara Chick hang dead light bulbs on her Christmas tree? Well, you're not gonna find that out until I show you, which is not gonna happen for a while yet, so don't hold your breath or nothing, cause you'll turn purple and then some. Friday I got completely annihilated. Saturday I went grocery shopping, yay. And then Saturday night, I got annihilated again with the Dean Star, and we watched on TV the debate. The debate over the public option. Yeah, I cannot believe I actually sat there and watched CNN for as long as I did, and I was like glued to my chair listening to all the closing arguments. I know I'm fighting to get into my 5-hour energy drink right now, like I need it right now, but yeah, I'm thirsty. So yeah, I sat there and watched that all Saturday night, and I actually cheered and hooted and hollered when the vote passed 220 to 215. Damn, I can tell you, I did not think that the vote was going to be that friggin' close. I really didn't. By 2 friggin' votes. Actually, technically speaking, it was 3 because you only need a majority vote to win, which I believe was 218. Yeah. So when that friggin' ticker hit 218, first I was excited. But then there was still like another 7.5 minutes left of voting time, and you know they can change their mind. If they vote, they can change it. They can change it. Which happened, I think, once or twice. Yeah, one of the Republicans actually voted yes, and then took it back. So I was worried that somebody was going to change their mind at the last second and freaking kill the vote. But it didn't happen. So tonight, I think at 7 o'clock, I get to find out what the Senate says. So, yeah, exciting, I know. I normally don't talk about politics, and to be perfectly frank with you, I don't usually get this excited over politics, but man, this is big news. This is a big deal. And yeah, I know there's going to be, a lot of this going on in the news with what's going on with healthcare and whatnot, but, you know, something had to be done, right? What I want to know is 2,000 pages. How long would it take you to read and digest 2,000 pages? Now, we're talking about friggin' bills here. We're not talking Harry Potter. I mean, I can digest a nice thick book like this in just, you know, a couple of days if I'm really into it, but I think they had like 36 hours. I don't know. They had a ridiculously small amount of time to actually read these 2,000 friggin' pages. I was like, oh my god! And when I actually downloaded it onto the computer and read it, and saw all the other crap that was in there. I mean, rights for Indians and crap. There was more in the bill about Indians than there was about people like us. Non-Indians. Oh, so what am I all excited and rabbiting on about? I don't know. I guess because my Monday is over. And what did I do on Sunday? Oh yeah, Sunday I woke up sore as hell, and then I got to rake all day and play with a leaf blower. And after I was done, Dean turned around and said, "And you complained when we first moved in that you didn't think we had enough trees." Yeah, guys, I really don't have any trees on my property, because we don't count shrubs as trees, and we don't count evergreen trees as trees because they don't molt. I guess they're trees, but yeah, we don't have any deciduous trees on our property, except for the one in the middle of my front lawn and the dead one on the corner of the property that has that weird fungus on it. So yeah, all of the leaves, all 25 bags that I bagged up this weekend, are from my neighbor's property. And now I'm knackered. I'm not knackered from raking. I'm knackered from blabbering on in your ear. And now it's Monday. Monday. So John, Ginger John, you've threatened to give me some nice juicy vlog ammo. And I wanna know, are you gonna do it? And are you going to participate? Because I hope you're not thinking, why do I have to deal with this, guys? Why do people park in such stupid places? Why would you park your car in the middle of a freaking driveway? I don't know. Meep, meep, meep. That was my backing up, my fancy schmancy backing up sound. So, I don't think I should drink this right now. I think I should go home and get a cold one out of the fridge, because this one's been in my pocket all day. Okay. Alright, I need to get some of this energy out. I don't know, I think I should join a sport, like, bitch face bashing. BFB, is there such thing as a BFB club? Oh, that would be so cool. I could put on my boxing gloves and get it all out. Alright, I really have to go now, because I'm getting out onto the main road and I don't need to be driving with interior car lights on, so I'm wrapping it up. I hope you are all doing well. Let's see what the week brings, shall we? And sprinkles of leafy goodness. Alright. Meh. Thanks for listening to me, Waffle. I'll see you later. Bye-bye now.